I move the 32740.
Second.
What page?
143.
Okay. Let's give you an opportunity to talk about your year.
Thank you very much. We have two proposed changes to our budget this year. One is with our conservation coordinator, because it is a part-time position, the number of hours are being reduced. At the same time, it's been 2 years since that position has been given an increase, so we're asking for a 1.25% increase. The net impact of that is a reduction from 28,922 to 28,290. We're also asking for a $1 an hour increase for our secretarial rate for keeping our meeting minutes. I went back as far as I could, which was about the year 2000, and haven't seen an increase at all for our secretarial rate since then.
What is the current rate?
$10 an hour.
And flat $10 an hour? And that's not built, that's not done per session, like we're done per session.
No, we do it on an hourly basis.
On an hourly basis.
And this year I asked the finance department to give me a printout on that, and it's averaged exactly 10 hours per month. And of course, we meet once per month.
And you're looking to go to 11?
Correct. So that will be a $120 increase in our budget. Everything else is flat. So actually, the net impact is a reduction in our budget from 33,252 to 32,740.
Okay. And just so that we're clear on this, because we can't see rates here, your part-time position, the end result on that, how many hours is she working now?
She's working 30. That'll be reduced to 29 hours.
So 30 hours to go to 29. And the rate?
She is currently at 1854. We're asking for an increase to 1877.
$18.54 to
$18.77.
23 cents an hour. 1.25%. Well, as we've said, we sometimes would rather see those smaller increments than get hit over the head with ketchup. But one thing you said, she hasn't gotten a raise for 2 years. I do believe that that position was given a raise last year.
Yeah,
correct.
It wasn't in last year's budget. It was
not
in the prior year's budget.
Not this year, but she started getting a raise last year.
Mm-hmm.
Yes,
was 9% or 9.25%.
9%.
And right. That kicked in, right. As I recall.
Well, that was halfway voted on in the 2012 town meeting, I believe.
That was last year.
That caused
last year.
That definitely happened last year. That definitely caused some excitement.
Yes.
Yeah, that was last year.
That was here.
Yes.
Yeah. That was on the board.
That was on the board.
Yes. You had the money in your budget. Yes.
All right. Christy, can we charge you with exactuating that for us and give us the date of the increase? Mm-hmm. For the secretary last year?
I will look into that for you.
Only because, I mean, we're talking about 23 cents here, but I thought we played catch-up last year. And then
you want
some.
A year and the amount?
The year, yeah, when it changed. If we can
amount.
Have the change right. Date, the last change date on that position. That's all.
It okay. Becomes, just so you know, that becomes an increasingly demanding position. When we first created that position, the role of the conservation coordinator was to basically work with people who were coming in with questions about whether or not they needed a special permit, The coordinator would go out to the property, do a site walk, make a preliminary determination as to whether or not a permit was required. If so, help them to fill out the application. Since then, it's grown. The conservation coordinator now sits on the planning review committee meetings. The conservation coordinator reviews condo operations and maintenance documents. The conservation coordinator also now signs off on all COs requests for properties where a special permit has been issued. So there's a lot more responsibility that's been added to the position since it was originally created.
Can you enlighten me, when it comes to, here you say that now has the responsibility of going over and reviewing condominium documents, is this for current owners, new owners?
This is for prospective new developers.
Prospective new developers?
Right.
Okay.
So when they come in and when they present their operations and maintenance manuals, the conservation coordinator is one of those people who will review those manuals to make sure that all the issues that should be addressed are being addressed.
Ahead of time?
Right.
And I would imagine that cuts down on how much we spend on legal after the fact.
We'd like to think so. Any review that you can do beforehand is obviously going to cut down on all the after fact, turning around and trying to catch up.
Is there any charge for doing this? I would think that
other departments? No.
This is a good spot for a user fee.
For ultimate consumers.
We as the Conservation Commission don't have the capability of charging fees like that. That would have to come through the planning board.
Is it something that could be discussed?
It can always be discussed.
Well, I'm
not trying to be flip with you.
No,
it can.
I mean, I
don't know where it
would
go. I
guess I'm throwing that out there, that this is an increased cost to the budget, mm-hmm. and no one likes the term user fees. However, if a developer is coming mm-hmm. to town mm-hmm. and wants to develop our town, and we're reviewing his documents, and we're spending manpower in reviewing those documents, I see nothing wrong with that developer having some investment in that review. Just a thought.
Yep, I don't disagree with you. Those documents have always come under review. We're just now having more eyes on those documents
right.
to make sure that the review is more thorough.
And it takes a while.
It does.
It takes a while. I know... from practical experience, some forms you used to be like one page long, and now with all the new regulations, they look more like a book and takes more time, and we're paying for it. So just throwing that out to you.
So I just wanted to give an understanding of the fact that, again, the responsibilities of the position have grown, and mm-hmm. so it becomes more challenging to get the work done.
Okay. Ready for questions?
Yeah.
Jerry, you want to start?
I was just going to make a motion to move this.
Well, you know, because everybody's going to have the opportunity to.
I have no questions. I think he does a great job. The Conservation Committee truly watches over encroachments of marshlands and stone walls down at the beach and, you know, their configurations and they get disturbed or not, and they get reconfigured.
Do you have any questions?
I'm very happy with them.
Thank
no
you.
No questions.
Joe? Sonny?
Your point about user fees, most towns collect money up front when a developer comes to them with a project. It's the area of the planning board, but I mean, since you're involved, you should be pushing for it. There's no reason why it should cost the taxpayers money. Somebody comes to the town with a project. The fee should be paid up front.
And there are fees that are assessed.
No,
they just don't
well
go
aware,
back to the
right.
conservation
raising
commission.
Some other fees. So.
Are you involved in every project or only some?
Me personally? Or the
commission.
We're involved in every project where there... We're involved in every project where there is a wetlands conservation district impact.
So only if there's a wetlands, not everything that's built.
But as far as the planning review committee is concerned, the conservation coordinator goes to every planning review committee whether or not the projects being discussed include those that have wetlands. Same thing applies to condo docks.
Okay.
generally review all of them. It's not only those where there are wetlands involved.
Yeah, Jay, why don't you, you're involved in the FEMA and the wetlands. Why don't you tell us a little about that?
Oh, we're not going to get into that tonight.
We did that last week.
Jim, okay. Michael?
Yes, I do have a comment to make. I have no problem with the budget, but I'd have a comment. Speaking of the fees, it's called impact fees. The planning board can do that. If we can nudge them into doing it, it's a darn good idea, because we get impact for school already. Impact fee for the town would be great. That would pay for his functionality, some of his expenses, and a few other things we do for free for some of the developers in town. That's why.
Brian?
Yes.
Okay.
Well said.
Jay, I have a question.
Sure.
Your position is an appointed position, correct?
Correct.
Okay, by the selectmen.
Correct.
And do you get paid?
Not too much.
Do you get paid the same that I get paid for being on this board?
I think I get a lollipop if I'm good.
You know what? I want to thank you. I watch the meetings, and you're always at the meetings. You and the other members of that committee do a very, very good job for this town. So thank you very much.
Well, thank you for that. I appreciate it.
Jay, I think you just made a statement. You said that the Conservation Committee coordinator attends all the planning review meetings?
Right. Well, planning, there's a specific planning review committee, the PRC.
Yeah,
they meet
right.
Once a month. Not every planning meeting where there is a project being reviewed. The planning review committee includes all of the department's heads. It includes building, police, fire, as well as planning, and as well as Conservation Commission. That was established, I think, about 3 or 4 years ago.
So that's where the wages come in for this employee to attend these meetings, right?
Well, that's one of the responsibilities.
And, now, does she work out of the planning office?
No, she has her own office that's just outside of the planning office.
Oh,
she
right.
works with the planning department, but she's
coordinated
separate.
With the planning department. I see. All right. That's all.
No questions.
No, I don't have any questions. I just, I'm surprised how much work they actually get done with the amount of the budget it is. So I'm not looking to haggle over anything. I think they do a great job with the little they have.
We're taxpayers, too.
Mm-hmm.
Did a great job.
Thank you.
Okay. So do I have a motion?
I'll make a motion that we move the... in favor of the $32,740 that's been proposed by the Board of Selectmen.
Second.
All those in favor? Opposed? Okay.
You should ask for more.
Thank you.
Thank you very
Thanks, everybody.
Much.
Appreciate it.
Good night.